talking about why so many of us overplan and stretch ourselves thin in quarter one. What then happens if you let yourself run with that instead of going back and readjusting? And we're gonna talk about how you can start planning your quarters to avoid that burnout towards the end of month two, beginning of month three. So I'm super excited to talk about this today. If you are new here, I am Brittany Berger, the founder of workbrighter.co, and this is the Brighter Broadcast, your 10, 15 minute-ish tip to work brighter and live smarter this week. I am really excited about today's topic. We're going to geek out about planning, and I'm going to show you inside of my Airtable base where I made and am keeping track of my plans. Lots of fun, geeky stuff. So if you follow Work Brighter or are a member of the Productive Unicorns community or any of that, you know that I love planning. I have always been a planner, but over the past year or two that I realized, as much as I love planning, I'm not actually good at it. Because a good plan is something that you can follow through on. It's something that's like manageable and doable. And with that, I seriously lacked. And for a while, I thought that I just had a follow through problem, that it was like my work ethic, or I just wasn't willing to do the work and I just needed to hustle more. Comment if you have ever felt like this too, if you felt like you just needed to do more and do better. And so I just kept thinking that that was the reason that I couldn't stick to the plans that I made for myself, and that I just needed to hustle harder. Oh, that phrase. But I've realized over the past year, I really figured out why I was making these plans I couldn't stick to, and it had nothing to do with my work ethic or my hustle or anything like that. I was just literally planning more than I was capable of doing. And after playing and experimenting for a few quarters and different game plans now, I understood that the main reason I did that is because whenever I was sitting down to plan a new quarter, I would jump straight to thinking of all of the new and exciting things I wanted to do, the things I wanted to create, the promotions I wanted to run, and things like that. I would jump straight into that when I started quarterly planning, without ever thinking about, all right, what work am I already bringing into this quarter? What work do I already have going on? So for example, I still spend a good half of my time on client work, yet I never really considered how much time client work takes in a week when I go to sit down my January, February, March plan. I was just saying like, all right, I'm going to plan all these new things for myself, and without actually having a good picture of how much time I had available for that work. I don't know what you plan in or how you create your quarterly plans. You can comment and let me know, but personally, I jump into usually a calendar or a project management tool. So for this quarter, I used Airtable. And normally I would just jump right into a blank Airtable or a blank document or calendar and just start writing down new projects and new things. It would be like I had a new blank slate. But in reality, my business didn't have that full clean slate. You know, I do client work 3 to 4 days a week for a few hours. I have ongoing work like email and social media, email marketing, creating content, maintaining the activities and events that we have going on in the Work Brighter Clubhouse, things like that. And so I'd never really mapped out how long that would take in a week for me. And so because of that, I never really had a good picture of how much free time I had available for any new items going in my quarterly plan. So this year, the first thing I did when I started quarterly planning was not anything to do with the future or new projects. It was to get a more accurate picture of how much I already had going on. Because normally when I sit down to plan, I always assume, for example, that I have 20 hours a week of working on my own business, since I aim to work 30 hours a week and I was estimating that I do about 10 hours a week of client work. So that was like my loose estimate. But then when I sat down and did this Airtable base and this planning that I'm about to show you, I realized, oh my God, I have half of that. I only have 10 hours a week for new projects. So it was so eye-opening to start my quarterly planning with just a general audit of how much I already have going on and how much time that takes, because I was way off base in estimating how much time things take. So I'm going to start my screen share now so that I can show you into what I did. So I started off with just mapping out all of my goals for quarter one. But then, so here's what I did when I first, oh, that's overwhelming looking, right? But it's really not as hard as it looks. But so when I started looking and planning out my quarter one, the first thing that I did was go to my calendar and map out all of the different things I do on an ongoing basis. Things like write the Work Brighter weekly newsletter, do these weekly live streams of the Brighter broadcast, moderate my different Facebook groups, client admin, and stuff like that. I put all of that into the Airtable base. I just realized that on the screen you can't see my face right now, but whatever. So I did all of these breakdowns. And so you can see that in more detail here. You can see that I made a filter, and this is not an Airtable tutorial right now. If you're interested in that, let me know, and I have a link for you. But we're not going to get into the details of how I actually set up the Airtable right now. Just focus on the content. So this is all of the ongoing work that I mapped out. So for example, for the client work project, I actually set aside 2 hours every day that I plan on doing client work. I blocked that off in my calendar now before doing anything else. Same with the Work Brighter Clubhouse. Before planning anything new for the Clubhouse, I blocked off how much time and what days and all that I would actually need to do this all on. And you can see the big thing here is that I have time estimates. And because, again, this is not an Airtable tutorial, but just this is how Airtable made it easy, is that this time estimate was automatically calculated for me. So you can see that in quarter one, even without doing anything new inside the Clubhouse, that is a total of 40 hours across 3 months. So that's already 12 hours a month of the Clubhouse. And it was a huge eye opener in realizing how much, excuse me. It was also a huge eye opener in looking at how much time I had available for client stuff. Because look at that. I spent, mapping out how much client work I currently do. That was 108 hours for the quarter. That's a huge, huge chunk of the quarter that is already accounted for in terms of planning and new projects and stuff like that. That time is already promised to my ongoing clients who I write for. And so having that available and all mapped out then allowed me to look at each week. So let me just scroll. Yeah. So again, this is one of the things that one of the reasons Airtable made it easy, but you could do this manually in anything. But so I was able to then go to the all of the weeks and see, like, all right, so this is how much time I have available this week on like aside from client work. And so then when I started mapping out new projects, like for example, I'm going to be writing a new welcome sequence for Work Brighter. I'm going to be creating an energy management challenge for us all that's going to be so, so much fun. And so I'm doing all of these new things too, but I was able to actually go look at my weekly breakdowns and say, like, oh, look, I have a good 10 hours on week six. That's a time where I'm going to want to do a lot of stuff in my own business. However, week three, next week, I have a lot of client work and ongoing stuff already happening. So that's not going to be a week that I plan a ton of stuff in terms of new projects. And that was just a huge, 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 I cannot understate how much of a difference this made for me in terms of my weekly planning and just planning out all of my quarters, because a plan can be beautiful, it can be organized, it can be advanced with all of these different filters and views like I have here. But all of these different views, all of these custom fields, that is not what makes this a good plan. What makes it a good plan is that I can stick to this. This is manageable. This is 23 hours a week. Never more than 30. This is 20 to 30 hours a week, as opposed to the 30 to 50 hours that I was accidentally planning for in the past. So what makes this a good quarterly plan is not how fancy it is. It is the fact that I am confident that this is manageable, this is doable, that even if I get knocked out for a few days with a cold like I did last week, that I can still stick to this. This is a plan that is going to happen, and that's what makes it a good plan. If you do want to use Airtable for this, amazing. If you want to use paper or a calendar, whatever. I don't care where you do it. What I care about is that you take time to bring your ongoing work into any new plans and account for that so that you have a realistic expectation of how much time is available for new projects. All right, so that is what I wanted to talk to you about today. That is what I'm really, really fired up about right now. I'm just so excited that I love planning, but I never knew how to create plans that I could actually stick to, and that was a huge bummer. But now that I have figured out this secret of making sure to bring my ongoing work in and to revisit how much time all of that would take, this is so easy. I am so excited, and I wanted to just share this tip with you. If you have any if you have any questions about this, comment below. I would love to help you start adjusting your quarter one plans to make sure that they're manageable and that there's something that you're still sticking to. Also, if you are interested in using the actual Airtable base that I created and used to lay out my quarterly plans and to account for all of my ongoing work, I am actually going to be making that available to members of the Work Brighter Clubhouse. So I will drop a link in the comments below, but if you're interested in this actual Airtable base that makes planning out manageable quarters super easy, just check out the Clubhouse. We would love to have you there and help you build brighter and better habits.